you bow with me, please? Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, holy and righteous is thy name, and we bow in thy presence and say you're the true and living God, and there's no one else. We're thankful for this congregation of thy people that we may gather here and sing songs of praise unto thee and worship thee and songs, and we pray that we will sing and offer unto thee our heartfelt thanks to praise thee, the only true and living God. We thank thee for the ability and the talents you give each one of us. We pray it as we gather in your name this afternoon to sing these songs, that it may be a joyous occasion, that we will enjoy singing and we will understand. We will sing with the spirit and with the understanding. Help us be a better people this day. We pray that we may be drawn closer to one another and love one another more as we love thee, our God, more and more. Forgive us of our sins that we may stand justified and purified in thy sight. We pray, Heavenly Father, that if it be possible, that the peace of God may be in each and every home. Look down on us with thy tender mercy and thy loving forgiveness. Be with us now as we further worship thee in songs. We're thankful for this congregation of thy people, and I pray for it today, that we'll be just the kind of people you'd have us to be, and that much good will be seen and done in this community and throughout the world. Be with us now as we walk the uneven journeys of life, if there's any left for us. And when we come to the end of life's way, save us without the loss of even one, for we pray in the name of Christ. Amen.
Tonight we have a song service, and for those that would like to, would lead songs after I'll lead a couple, and then we'll go around. The first song will be 235. 235.
I have found a friend in Jesus. He's everything to me. He's the fairest of 10,000 to my soul. Sorrow, he's my comfort. In trouble, he's my savior. Lord, no tender
539-539.
I heard an old, old story, how a Savior came from glory, how he gave his life on Calvary to save a wretch like me. I heard about his groanings, of his precious blood atoning. Then I repented of my sin and won the victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and bought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me story, and some sweet day I'll sing up there the song of victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and bought me with his redeeming blood.
Why did my Savior come to earth and to the humble go? Why did he choose a lonely birth? Because he loved me so. He loved me.
He loved me. He loved me.
Let's stop right there. That's the wrong melody to that song. Let's do number 366. Let's try that song. Y'all were doing a real good job, though. Well, thank you. Let's see if we can get this one.
How shall the young secure their heart and guard their lives from sin? In thy word, the choicest rules impart to keep the conscience clean.
The conscience
to keep.
prayer is still here. I count it all joy to be part of an eldership that has the willingness and the ability to lead singing, especially the one who just led could do it more often. Amen. 255. 449. 449. Six seventy-eight. We'll save the chorus after the second verse. Two verses and then the chorus. 678.
Oh, 177. Everybody is singing so well tonight. Sounds like about 500 in here. And they're doing a great job. Jimmy, he was holding out on the sun. Let's stand. 177.
Thank you. Where did they all go, Spin? There's but many more there a while ago, weren't there? Wonderful singing. We really appreciate your presence and the participation of everybody in a wonderful song service. Some of us, after we're dismissed, are going to come right down here and sing a little while. Spin's going to hang around for a little bit. And so if you want to join in a little group singing, then if you need to go, take off. But some of us are going to come right down here and sing, just so you know. But we do want to close this service with the Lord's invitation. Reminded of the passage in Matthew chapter 11, beginning in verse 28, which Jesus said, "Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest for your souls, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light." That's the Lord himself inviting whoever to come learn of him. Of course, we learn through a study of the Word of God, and upon hearing that Word, we believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. Because of that faith, we should be willing to turn away from sin, confess that faith, be buried with our Lord in baptism. We can be a child of God. And if you haven't done that tonight, certainly you ought to give that serious consideration. As a child of God, we can wander away. We can be led away with the ways of the world. We can be drawn aside. We can be overtaken again. As Peter said in 2 Peter chapter 2, talked about those who had once escaped the pollutions of the world through the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and are entangled therein again and overcome. He says the latter end is worse than the beginning, but we don't have to stay there. Through our recognition of sin in our lives, willingness to confess that sin, ask God's forgiveness, he is willing to forgive. And tonight, if you need to do that, we extend the Lord's invitation as we stand together and sing the song selected.
Hopefully each one has enjoyed the service as much as I have tonight. For those that are visiting, we're certainly glad that you've decided to be with us. We ask you to be back at your next opportunity. And if you are traveling away from us, we wish you safe travels. Reminder of those that are on our prayer list, you're asked to remember Sydney as he has a heart catheterization this coming Tuesday at Tanner in Carrollton. Frieda Gray has also been able to come home. She is now continuing in therapy and home health and so forth, but we should still remember her, of course. Barbara Cron has some more tests upcoming this Tuesday, and we should remember her as well, and several others that we've been mentioning for some time. Rosemary Evans turns 90 years old this coming Tuesday, May the 31st. She is at the Countryside Health Center nursing home facility in Buchanan For those who have the opportunity to send her a card or visit, she would certainly appreciate that. Are there any others that we should make mention of? Brothers Keepers Group 1 meets this Saturday, the 4th of June, at the home of Jimmy and Jan Adams. There's a sign-up list in the foyer. Festivities begin officially at 5 o'clock, but if you want to get there a little early and wet a hook, you are certainly invited to do that. Next Sunday begins our summer quarter. After the evening service, we'll have our potluck and kick off officially for summer quarter. We'll also combine two other activities into that event, teacher appreciation and also an official send-off to Blake and Honey Wilson. Many of you are probably well aware by now that Blake has accepted a position in Huntsville, Alabama. We really hate to see them go, but they're going to do it anyway despite our objections. So they will also have a brief recognition of Blake and Honey leaving us, and we'll also have a money tree for those who want to participate in that. You're invited to do so. Next area-wide singing is at the West Georgia congregation in Carrollton this coming Friday night, June the 3rd, 7 p.m. Lord's Supper's kept prepared for those that wish to observe it. Once we stand to sing final song, go through this door, second door on the left, and there will be someone there waiting to serve you. We look forward to seeing each of you at our next service Wednesday at 7 p.m. Should we mention anything else? 429 is our final song. If you'll stand, we'll sing. Be dismissed.
I know the Lord.
God, we thank you for this beautiful day. We thank you for every blessing that you bless us with daily. We're thankful for this song service. We pray that we have understood the words and that we've praised you tonight. We pray for those that were mentioned this morning as being sick. We pray that you will bless them and help them to recover. Pray that you will be with the ones that are having procedures, that their procedures might be successful. Pray, Heavenly Father, that you'll be with us every day as we go to work and school and wherever we might be. Pray that you might help us to give us the courage to live good lives. We also pray that you might forgive our sins. In Christ's name, amen.